Good morning. Today is January 10th, and this is Kids Connect, Faith at Home Kids Connect. And today, on the 10th of January, this is the first Sunday after the Epiphany, and this is the day where we talk about the baptism of our Lord. And so, with you children, I kind of want to talk about baptism. And, you know, Jesus' baptism, kind of want to talk about our own baptism as well. So I have the baptismal font right here. I know some of you were baptized right here, here at Messiah. Some of you may have been baptized elsewhere. But I want to talk about baptism, Jesus' baptism. But I want to start off, first of all, by singing Children of the Heavenly Father.
Children of the Heavenly Father, safely in His bosom gathered, sharing our Lord's one another, such a refuge it was given. God is on the pen and paper, in His holy course a blur, from all evil things He bears, and in mighty arms He bears. Neither life nor death shall ever from the Lord His children sever. To heaven things He showeth, and their sorrow all He knoweth. Though He giveth or He taketh, not His children ne'er forsaketh. It's the loving, the solely, to preserve them pure and holy.
Children of the Heavenly Father. You know, what a beautiful hymn to sing when you think about all of us being children of God, you know, especially through the waters of baptism, that we are God's children, that He is our Heavenly Father. You know, on the baptism of our Lord, we think about Jesus going to John the Baptist to be baptized. And John the Baptist, you know, he said, "Why are you coming to me?" I mean, John realized that Jesus was perfect. And John was not, just like all of us, we're sinful. And so Jesus didn't get baptized in order to be forgiven of sins because He never sinned. He was perfect. But He was baptized to kind of fulfill the law and to show us the importance of baptism. You know, He was baptized, the voice from heaven called out, "This is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased." And the Spirit of God descended upon Jesus as He was being baptized. And we think about our own baptisms. You know, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit were all present at Jesus' baptism. Of course, Jesus was the one, the Son being baptized, the voice is the Father, the Spirit is the Holy Spirit. And when we're baptized in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As I baptize a child, oftentimes I'm holding a baby in my arms, and here's a shell that I dip into the water. And as I hold the head of the baby, I pour the water. And I say, "I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Father, Son, and Holy Spirit were present at Jesus' baptism. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is present at our own baptism. You know, and we use that Word of God, with that Word of God combined with that water, that wonderful things happen to us. First of all, we are children of God, adopted as God's children. And as God's children, then we inherit the blessings of forgiveness, the promise of life everlasting. And so when we're baptized, yes, we are forgiven of our sins. Baptism also promises us everlasting life. No matter how long we'll live here in this world, we belong to God. And even when we leave this world, you know, that we will always be God's children. That He will always be our God, and you will always be His children. You know, beautiful, wonderful things happen in the waters of baptism. And you know, we oftentimes will talk about us remembering our baptism. You know, it's interesting that I was baptized. I was 1 month old. Many children are baptized after 1 week, or 2 weeks, or 3 weeks. Oftentimes within the first year, many are baptized. And of course, we cannot remember back when we were only 1 year old. Or, you know, we can't can't remember when we were babies. We don't remember those times. But when we remember our baptism, we remember the fact that we were baptized as a child. And when we were baptized, we became God's children. And that he promises always to be with us. So when we remember our baptisms, we remember all that God has done for us. And so, brothers and sisters, children of God, just know that you are God's children. We are blessed to have our earthly families, our mom and our dads, and brothers and sisters, and grandmas and grandpas. But more importantly, yes, we have those families, but we are also part of the family of God. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. And so we have a connection because we are all God's children. And that's a wonderful thing. And so with that in mind, I want to lead you in a prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you so much as we think about baptism, as we think about us being baptized, and us being forgiven of our sins, and that we have the promise of eternal life, that we are part of the family of God, our church family. We have our earthly families, but we also have our church family. And dear Lord, we thank you for that. Continue to bless us. Help us to remember our baptism. Help us to remember the fact each and every day, no matter what happens, that we are always your children. And we pray everything in Jesus' name. Amen. Once again, thank you. Every week, I want to do a Faith at Home Kids Connect. And so that that you children can always go and maybe see a Kids Connect devotion, sing a song. I always like singing songs with you. So we can sing a song, kind of hear a Bible story, and just remember all that God has done. So once again, I hope to see you next week.